The Battle of the Somme started in July 1, 1916 and ended in November 1916. It was said to be one of the bloodiest battles ever. Many people thought that this battle symbolized the horrors of World War I.
Many of these Canadian soldiers fought for the first time in the Battle of the Somme. Many were part of Kitchener's Volunteer Army, which was a successful recruitment that led the new army out to battle.
The battle started with a week-long artillery bombardment of the German lines. There were 1,739,000 shells fired at the Germans.
The Germans had deep trenches, bomb-proof shelters, and wire entanglements 40 yards vast. Defenses could only be attacked with the prospect of success after a careful artillery preparation.
The British soldiers advanced across a 25-mile front. By November 1916, the British lost 420,000, the French lost 200,000, and the Germans lost 500,000 men. The casualties exceeded England's and Canada's capacity to care for the wounded because of the shortage of hospital facilities.
Halifax and Quebec ports were not ready to receive the wounded and the dead. 10 rail cars carried wounded men on the Canadian Pacific Railroad and the Intercolonial Railways.
The first military hospital was located in Halifax in the summer of 1917. Camp Hill provided residences to the officers and staff. Within the hospital, there was a training center and a recreational hall. It was accessible by road and trail. In mid-1917, they acquired 5,600 beds. At the end of 1917, they acquired 13,802 beds, and 1,428 of those beds were for tubercular patients.
The patients had ready access outdoors from each of the two-story buildings. Each wing had large windows as well as large verandas where they would enjoy beautiful views.
The Canadian Red Cross roots date back to 1885. It started with an organization to aid men from the South African War in 1899. The World War I Red Cross volunteers knitted socks, sweaters, sewed bandages and linens, and sent them to war-torn Europe. Red Cross raised large sums of money to purchase supplies and aid. The majority of the volunteers worked overseas in military hospital or casualty clearance stations. They were often placed in front lines and ministered injuries. No one trained them.
Volunteers would also comfort and tend to patients under active battle conditions. Most of the patients had dysentery, frostbite, and other severe injuries and diseases. The nurses were not immune to influenza or spinal meningitis. In total, there were 46 nurses killed in the line of duty.
On May 9, 1918, the Canadian General Hospital in Etaps was bombed. The bomb killed 56 people, including four nurses. On June 27, 1918, the Canadian hospital ship Landovery Castle was torpedoed. On board, there was a Canadian crew and medical staff. 258 people died and 24 survived. 14 Canadian nurses perished. A nurse during wartime was a very dangerous job. They put themselves in the line of fire to save the lives of the wounded.
Florence Nightingale helped soldiers in World War I. Her diary was found, and inside there are many touching letters written by soldiers she treated in the trenches that were tucked inside her diary. Her pristine Red Cross uniform was also found.
Lucy Kate Kitty Curd was a nurse as well. Lucy was born in Tunbridge Wells in 1881. She worked in military hospitals in Le Havre, Calais, Rouen, and Etaps. While she was working in the voluntary aid department, she held the role of assistant Red Cross nurse. Lucy won 5 medals to honor her dedicated work as a nurse. She acquired the Red Cross second class silver badge that was wrapped in a piece of lace and Queen Victoria's chemise.
Alice Margaret McKinnon was a nurse in World War I, and she also happens to be Katie's great-grandma. Alice was born in 1894 in Bourne and later moved to St. Neots. She is the daughter of Margaret Holdick and Frederick White Holdick and had one sister, Nellie. Alice became interested in nursing at a young age. She started out nursing by helping wee babies and advised moms on food and clothing at nursing school. Alice first worked in St. Bartholomew's Hospital and then she was transferred to Woolwich Hospital. The other hospital she gave her service to was Hospital No. 24 in Etaps. In 1999, she sadly passed away at the age of 105.
Lieutenant Colonel John McCrae was born on November 30, 1972 in Guelph, Ontario. Mr. McCrae joined the Highland Cadet Corps when he was 14 years old, and he joined the militia when he was 17 years old. During his years at university, Mr. McRae was a member of the Queen's Own Rifles of Canada, and he later became company captain. He received his Bachelor of Arts from the University of Toronto in 1894, and his Bachelor of Medicine from the University of Toronto in 1898. Two of his students that he tutored to help pay his tuition were among the first women doctors in Ontario. After Mr. McRae graduated from medical school, he set up his own practice as a pathologist in 1909.
Mr. McRae started off as an artillery subaltern in the South African War during 1899 and 1900. When the outbreak of World War I began, he was appointed brigade surgeon to the 1st Brigade, the Canadian Field Artillery. Mr. McRae held the rank of major and second in command. In 1915, he was transferred to No. 3 McGill Canadian General Hospital in Dans-Camiers, France. He was appointed as Chief Medical Services.
Mr. McRae wrote the poem In Flanders Fields during the Second Battle of Ypres in 1915. His poem was first published in the magazine Punch that same year. When he was in university, he wrote 16 poems and several short stories, and they were published in a variety of magazines, including Saturday Night.
Mr. McRae suffered from severe asthma all his life and acquired pneumonia in 1918. Sadly, when he died, he was only 45 years, 1 month, and 29 days old. He is buried with full military honors in Wimmera Cemetery, which is north of Boulogne. We thank him for saving many lives and risking his life for Canadians.